This morning, for a short discourse, I'd like to share with you a story that is entitled The Dirty Laundry Story. A young couple moved into a new neighborhood. The next morning, while they were eating breakfast, the young wife sees the neighbor hanging out her laundry outside. That laundry is not very clean, she said. She doesn't know how to wash correctly. Perhaps she needs better laundry soap. The husband looked on her but remained silent. Every time the neighbor would hang her washing to dry, the young woman would make the same comment. Sometime later, the woman was surprised to see a nice clean laundry on the line and said to her husband, "Look, she has learned how to wash correctly. I wonder who taught her." The husband said, "I got up early this morning and cleaned our windows." Lesson to the story: if your windows are dirty, so will you see dirt in others too. What you see in others is indeed the reflection of your inner self. So it is with life, that what we see when we are watching at other depend on the purity of our windows through which we look. It is easy for us to condemn, to discuss others, their lives and things that really doesn't concern us. And we tend to forget that our windows may not be that clean after all. If you are good, you will see good. My friends, for a short discourse this morning, I've captioned it, "The Dirt That Cleanses From Within." Shall we pray? Most High and Loving Father, indeed, O God, we say thank you for this, another beautiful day. Thank you for the means in which we can meet, O Lord, as we are about to go into your word. Empty me of self, O Lord, as I speak. Let it be directly from your throne room. Be with us now as we journey, in Jesus' name. Amen. Your Bible and turn to 1 John chapter 45, verse 50. And I read in your hearing, "Philip found Nathanael and told him, 'We have found the one who Moses wrote about in the law, and about whom the prophet also wrote, Jesus of Nazareth, the son of Joseph.'" "Nazareth? Can anything good come from there?" Nathanael asked. "Come and see," said Philip. When Jesus saw Nathanael approaching, he said of him, "Here truly is an Israelite in whom there is no deceit." "How do you know me?" Nathanael asked. Jesus answered, "I saw you while you were under the fig tree, before Philip called you." Nathanael declared, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are King of Israel." Jesus said, "You believe because I have told you I saw you under the fig tree." My friends, for a short course this morning, as we journey back in the time of history, we need to recognize the climate of the time of the in that time. My friends, 2,000 years had passed since the promised Messiah was to come. 63 years have passed since the Roman legionaries under Pompey has conquered Palestine and taken Jerusalem. The helmet, broad sword, and the eagles of the Roman legionnaire were universally felt. Surely, in the heart of many, the question that was asked, where is the promised Messiah? As we look at our world today, we too might be asking, where is Jesus in all that we are going through? Life as we know it have changed thanks to the approach of Corona. And many of us are being tested day in and day out as to what will really happen in our life. My friends, many of us are asking questions, and while many question, there are many that is looking at others and coming up to many conclusions. I ask you this morning, what is your window looking like? Are you seeing the real beauty in the light of many? Or are you still struggling to see the clear, clean glass in others' life? My friend, the story reminds us that there are many of us that have dirty glasses, and we need to get them clean so that we can see the good in others. There are many of us that is also looking for the promised advent of Christ Jesus. But I'm here to remind somebody this morning that Jesus Christ is still alive. Oh, my friends, despite where you're at right now on your spiritual journey, despite where you're at right now in your physical journey, I am here to tell you this morning that Jesus Christ is still on the throne. The promise that was made to us over 2,000 years ago still reigns today. And we too shall be just like Nathaniel saying, "You are the King of Israel." My friends, what are you going through today? What is your struggle in life today? I am here to tell you that despite what you're going through, Jesus Christ reigns supreme. Oh, there's somebody this morning under the sound of my voice that might be looking for some hope. Well, I'm telling you this morning that your hope can come from Christ Jesus. Oh, there is somebody this morning that is wondering, you know, how will they find the necessary finances to take care of their family? But I'm here to tell you this morning that Jesus Christ still provides. Oh, there is somebody this morning that their relationship, their marriage is on the rocks. And they're wondering, oh man, we have come so far, but right now it seems like we are at the end of the rope. But I'm telling you, my friends, that there is hope, and it is in Christ Jesus. Oh, if you remember the song, they say, "Weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning." There is a joy that Jesus gives. There is a joy that you receive that no one can give but Christ Jesus. Despite where you're going through, I heard Sister Burns tell you earlier that before you come to listen to Joy Praise, you should get into your personal relationship with Christ. The reason why we're having so much problem in our life is because we are forgetting to talk to the source first thing in our morning. I remember one preacher said that, you know, what you need to do, you need to take your bedside slippers and push them deep up under the bed so that when you get up off your bed in the morning, you must get on your knees to reach under the bed to get those slippers. And when you get those slippers, don't forget why you put them there. And while you're down there, just get on your knees and pray to God. My friends, we need to tap into the source. Life is not going to get any easier. We need to be under the anointing of the Lord every day, every second, every moment, because that is the only way that you can have the hope in Christ Jesus. Oh, why are we going through this? You may ask, Elder. The reason why we go through challenges is because Jesus is bragging about us. So look at your situation and ask yourself, boy, what does Jesus say this morning? I have often learned that when individuals, you know, have all that they have to say about me, that I should count myself lucky. Just think about it. If you're doing bad, they don't really talk about you. But when you're doing good for Christ, oh, they talk about you. So when you're going through your crucibles, when you're going through your challenge, just remember that Christ Jesus is saying, "Hey, Ella J, I want to talk about you today. Hey, Sister Burns, I want to talk about you today. And while I'm talking about you, you will find the strength in me, Christ Jesus." But the only way you can find the strength is if you tap into the source. Oh, friends, we must go through trials. We must go through troubles, but we can have the victory in Christ Jesus. Oh, what is the dirt that cleans from within? I'm here to tell somebody this morning that Christ Jesus, the son of Joseph, came from a place that many people believe that nothing good could come from. I'm here to tell you this morning that individuals might be looking at you. Individuals might be talking about you, that you can't do nothing good. You'll never amount to be anything good. But I'm here to remind you this morning that if Jesus Christ is in your life, that you can be something good. I'm here to tell you this morning, despite where you come from, you are here by faith, Because Jesus Christ is in you. What are you going through this morning? As you look back at your life, can you reflect as to where you have come from? Can you just imagine for a moment what life was like 10 years ago? And look at your life presently. Gracefully, we are growing day by day for Christ Jesus. Gracefully, as we face our challenges one by one, we are gaining the victory in Jesus' name. My friends, what are you facing this morning? Is too much for you? Are you feeling that there's no hope because your finances are getting so low? Your health conditions are getting so bad. Well, I'm here to tell you this morning, my friends, that you can have the victory because there is still hope, and the hope is in Christ Jesus. My friends, despite where your life is this morning, I'm here to tell you that Jesus Christ can change you. That despite where your life sit today, I'm here to tell you that the promise of the coming Messiah is still real. I'm here to remind somebody that despite how the world look right now, that it's about to get a lot worse. It is about to get a lot worse, but there is hope, because as long as Jesus reigns supreme in our life, we can have the victory. My friends, whatever it is that you face today, whether it's struggle on the job, whether it's the problem of life, I'm here to tell you this morning, there is hope, and it is in Christ Jesus. I encourage you that as you get up each morning, make it a priority to get on your knees and talk to God as he recharge you for a new day. Oh, there are many of us that was planning to leave home this morning without, you know, speaking to God. But I'm so happy that you stopped by this morning, because I'm reminding you to talk to God before you leave home today. So anything that will come your way, you will have the victory. Oh, my listening friends, what are you going through today? I am here to tell you that Jesus Christ can cleanse you. Don't look back at your old way, but look forward to the transformation that God has made in your life. My friends, I don't know where you're sitting today. I don't know what you're looking at even now, but I know in whom the future lie, and in Christ Jesus. My friends, I'm here to tell you this morning that it doesn't matter what you're facing. There is a song that we sing. It says, through it all, I've learned to trust in Jesus. I've learned to trust in God. Oh, through it all, my friends, I've learned to depend upon my Lord. I don't know about you, but the God that I serve, he's such a loving God. He's such a cheerful God. I can't just keep silent. I have to tell somebody that Jesus Christ still remains. But I'm here to tell you that it doesn't matter what you're facing today. Jesus Christ can take it all. This morning, I don't know what you're facing, but if you're in need of prayer, just raise your spiritual hand wherever you are. And I know that the Holy Spirit is seeing you right now. And as I conclude, I pray that as we pray, Jesus Christ will have the victory. Shall we pray? Most high and loving Father, right now, O God, your people have their hand raised, O God, asking you, O God, to come into their life. Father, you know exactly what they're going through. And, oh, Father, you know exactly where they are even now. Father, as we look at the story of the dirty window, Lord, we know that there is somebody right now that individuals have condemned, but you, oh God, will have the victory in that individual life. Father, the finances, oh Lord, the health, oh Lord, the marital problem, oh Lord, even now, oh God, we place them in your hands, and we ask, oh God, that you take charge. Father, we ask, oh God, that you touch these individuals wherever they are. Wash them, oh God, from the crown of their head to the sole of their feet. Father, do that in them that only you and you alone can do. Father, help them to recognize, oh Lord, that they are not hearing this devotion by chance, oh Lord, but help them to recognize that you have ignited a spirit of change from today onward. Father, we pray, oh God, that wherever they are, that they will turn their problem, turn their situation into your hands. And when all shall be said and done, O God, indeed you will be glorified. Father, be with us all as we journey today. Help us, O God, to remember in whom our anchor lies, and that is in you, Christ Jesus. And whatever I fail to ask, O Lord, fail not to grant unto us, I pray. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Amen.